Good morning folks, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we'll be learning about the allocation of various components on the scooter. Very much like motorcycle, many electrical components are kind of arranged here and there. But the thing is, in a scooter, the prime objective have always been to hide components so that they are not really that visible and obvious. So many times you find a difficult choice being made while allocating places for those things. So in our scooter also that has been done, keeping in mind that not too many things are, you know, visible. So let's start with identifying them. You will find most of the horn cast area that has been utilized to house mainly four components, or five components to be precise. The first one is, obviously, you can see the ignition switch over here. That's the 4.1, indicating that it's for the electric start models. The next to it is a green box, or maybe in your case it will be blue or red box. That's basically a horn adapter. Next to it, you have a buzzer which buzzes whenever your indicators are switched on. Subsequent to that, obviously, you have a horn over here. Doesn't really need much introduction. Next to that, you have a PRD relay which sends input signals once the clutch is depressed to the cutout relay over here. See that? To learn more about the components over here, we'll have to take out this battery box. Here we are. Okay, so the component in my hand is called the CDI unit, which we have over here, and it's in pretty good shape as the engine was starting without much fuss. This blue thing is called the electronic flasher, which helps, or for that matter, which keeps the indicators flashing or blinking while you turn and switch them on. The component over here is called the RR unit, which converts the AC power into DC power and then charges the battery. The unit over here that you are seeing is called cutout relay, which basically is very much essential for a self-starting scooter. So that's the list of the components on this side. Apart from that, there's also a fuse box, as you can see over here. It has a screw type fuse inside, which can be turned and taken out. So that's about it. These two leads obviously are for the battery, and that's the battery box. Coming to the other side, the ST coil is placed over here. Then here you have the spark plug. Here you have the junction box so that all the wires could be neatly arranged. And that's finally your starter motor. So that's the basic, you know, overview of the location of various electrical components on this scooter. And that's about it. Coming at the top of the handle, we have a speedometer which is connected via a 8-point connecting socket. As you can see, this is 3 point, these are 5 additional points. Now apart from that, you have a switch going through this direction, and that's the clutch switch which feeds the input to PRD relay, which finally from here sends signal to the cutout relay over there, and that decides when to start the motor and when not to start it. Here you have the switch assembly to switch on the headlamps, and this is for dim and dipper. Now this one is for obviously the horn thing, and here you have the turn indicator. Apart from that, another switch that you have over here is this one, which lights up the rear tail lamp once you depress the brake lever. So that's the basic of, you know, basic information about the entire electrical circuit of the scooter. So in this video, we'll be seeing just these things. Should you need any other information, I'll definitely be letting you know. In the next video, what we'll be doing is, like, we'll be taking out all the cables and other stuffs, but we'll be taking that out very carefully because we intend to use that. And before taking them out, we'll obviously be checking various components if they are working or not. Should they not be functional, we'll definitely be replacing them. So that would be all folks. I hope you guys really enjoyed the entire video. Till the next time, stay tuned, build it, ride it.